Hey everybody, OVW here. This is a little quick video of my little updo. So you want to see how I did this? Then stay tuned.
Hey everybody, OVW here. This is just a quick little video because my hair has been in this twist style for going on, I think, 2 weeks. And so I'm going to be putting it in a little style because I'm going to deliver some hats tomorrow, and so I'm just kind of getting tired of the twist thing. I would take the twist out, but it's raining outside, and I know that the twist is just going to be a big poof once it's done, so I figured I'd just put it in a style. Now, I posted a picture of this style maybe a week ago, and so I'm just going to re-attempt it. You know how sometimes you do a style and you can't get it the same way? Well, hopefully this is not the case. So I retwisted these here. And because it was a little frizzy, and because this is going to be my front, I want it to be smooth. Now, some of these, as you can see, are a little frizzy as well, but I'm not going to bother. Even on this side, they are a little frizzy, but I'm not going to really bother with them. I don't tie my hair up at night because I sleep on a silk pillowcase, so I don't tie it up unless I really, really need to, but I don't. So what I'm going to do is just like pin curl these up, except my very front. Okay. So I'll show you what style I'm trying to recreate. Yeah. So that's what I'm trying to recreate. I got the idea from Mahoganknots. I have her link down at the bottom to that actual tutorial. I thought her hair was really, really cute. I think it's when her hair was a little bit shorter, but I love watching her videos and her tutorials. They're really helpful. So Mahoganknots, if you're watching, thank you so much for this tutorial. So I'm going to put that back. And so I'm just going to start in the back first. And normally I use one, but some of these are kind of small. Let's see, like right here I use two, so I'm going to use two right here too. So I'm just going to twist it on itself like so. And then lay it down. Then take my bobby pin, and these are really small bobby pins. Like they only like an inch wide. So they're really hard to open too. Hopefully my hair stay like that. Yeah. It's kind of hard to open these. So kind of see if you can see. So I'm kind of going to go under, but I'll make sure it's going to catch the top piece there. Like so. I hope you guys are able to see that. Like that. Okay. So I'm just going to do some more. I'm trying to have this on my finger already like this because they're really hard to open. So I'm going to go right underneath that one. I'll turn this way. So kind of wrap it around itself. Then go underneath it. And make sure it catches. And if the bobby pin's showing, I don't care. Like so. Alright. So I'm going to do another one here. I'm going to do these two together. I guess you guys can see. Like so, like that. Okay? So I'm just going to do more. It's going to continue doing all of them. Sometime I may use two twists, and sometime I may just use one, depending on how wide the twist is. Because as you can see, some of them are really skinny. Like this one's really skinny, and then you got a fatter one here. So some of them I may use two, and the other one I may use just one. So I'm going to continue on until I get like to the front. sides, and then I'll come back, all right? Okay, so I think I'm done with the back area, so I'll show you guys. Hopefully you can see it. I hope it looks right. I don't care if it's like a little messy. Let me do this one right here. I think I'm going to, let's see, am I going to use two? Yeah, I'll twist these two up. So yeah, I don't have many bobby pins left, so I'm gonna have to make this work. Okay, so I'm looking in the mirror in front of me. So I'm gonna start putting two and two together. So I got this side done. And the back. So now I have to work on this here. Now I only have like three, maybe four bobby pins left. So I'm gonna have to try to make this work. Okay, so let's see. Let's start up at the top here. So I am out of bobby pins now, so I'm going to find some more, and I found a few more, and they're bigger, so this works perfect. So let's see, I'll twist this last one up. Okay, so I got all of them done. So, got the sides, the back, hope it's not too messy, and then this side. All right, so now to work with this here. So I'm trying to think if I should do one more, like right in this area up top, or just pull it all over like that. Let's see how it'll look if I did maybe two more. Let's see. Okay, so I'm not quite sure how that looks, but it'll work. So with this here, I'm just gonna pull to the side to have a little, swoop action going here. twist it up on itself just a tad, just butt the ends. Set it right on the side here. I'm kind of going to have it go around the first twist here, the last twist I did on the side. Okay, so I got that to go around that twist. And so, see this little one just got a mind of its own. I kind of flat twisted that down. So I'm just gonna pin it. I kind of want them all to stick together. So just kind of pin it like that. Yeah. And so then that's the style. Then whatever pieces I see sticking up, I kind of repin it so it'll stay back down like so. And I think that is it. And then, oh, my eyebrows are looking a mess. Need to get them threaded. So then you just put your accent piece like right up in there like that. And you are good to go. And yeah. So this is just my little pinup updo. I think the first time I did it was better. It's always harder to recreate a second time. But I definitely have to make sure I have enough bobby pins. And so there you have it, my little updo. I kind of want these to come down a little bit. A little bit more. So that is my updo. This is like the second time you're attempting an updo other than just pulling it back. But a little more stylish, you know. Other than just taking them down and my twist be looking a mess. Or I think this was better. So there it is, and then I probably just get a little bit of oil on my hands and then kind of pat it dry, which is my oil here. This is my little concoction of like 10 different oils. I mean, from tea tree oil, castor oil, aloe vera oil, whole bunch of stuff, coconut oil, whole bunch of stuff, just all in one. So just kind of rub it on my hands like so. And just kind of, so it won't look so dull and dry looking, but still give it a little bit of, make it look a little glossy. So yeah, I mean, I'm nothing like the hair gurus on here, but I'm definitely learning how to deal with my hair. As I said in another video, me and my hair are finally starting to be one with one another. So I'll turn around again so you guys can see. So there it is again. And I'll probably be taking these twists out soon. But it's been like 2 weeks and I'm loving this. So here it is again. So I'm liking it. I'm liking it. So yeah, I see a couple of places I need to kind of pin down. But to try to close up some spaces. So I'll probably fix some because I can feel some open spaces. And then I just make my twist. When I twist them on itself, just make it a little bit wider so it'll hide the spaces. So there is my twist up updo. And yeah, try it yourself. It's really, really easy. I don't think it matters how long your hair is. I think you could do it with shorter hair, shorter than mine, and even longer than mine. I think Mahoganknots' hair was much longer than mine, and hers came out really, really nice. So thanks for watching this video. I just thought I'd do this video to share my little hairstyle that I am loving with you guys. And I will see you guys in the next video. Love you guys. God bless. Remember to keep God first in your life and everything else secondary. Bye.